Hello and welcome to you all on this 14th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and happy Independence Weekend to you all. We are not taking up a collection during any of the Masses this weekend. Instead, we have baskets for you which to place your offering or donation into as you leave. One will be at the back centre entrance and one in front of the altar here. Thank you for your generosity. We have song sheets in each pew for you to use. Please place them at the ends of the pews on your way out today, ready for us to collect, or you may take them home with you. And please take a bulletin with you too. They are in the slots by the doors as you exit. After each Mass, we need help with disinfecting all of the pews, etc. If you are willing and able to help today, please come into the link to collect supplies from me straight at the end of the Mass. Thank you. It's time to silence your cell phones, please. Two important announcements for our visitors. One, for the safety of everyone present here today, we ask you all to leave your mask on till you leave the church grounds, so for the duration of the Mass. And we have a custom in our parish. At the end of the Mass, we all kneel and silently say three Hail Marys for the next one amongst us to be called home by God. You are welcome to join us. Thank you, and may God bless you today and always.
Please join. Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn on your song sheet found in the pew. Come now, Almighty King, number 562.
Sins and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just savior is he. Meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim, and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm is Psalm 145, I will praise your name. And the refrain is, I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit. If only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As Father said at the beginning of the Mass, Happy 4th of July. I hope you're all enjoying the long holiday weekend. As we celebrate Independence Day, please take some time to contemplate what independence means and the sacrifices that were made to get us here. arrive safely, and please be careful with fireworks. And this public service announcement has been brought to you by the old deacon of the parish. Most of you probably know that this old deacon does not watch TV. I don't have cable or a dish. I don't watch NBC or ABC or CBS or Fox or any of the other regular broadcast news. And please, don't ask me if I've seen the latest episode of Reality Island or whatever, or some comedy soap, because I haven't. And I'm not interested. And I don't really want to know, so don't tell me. That does not mean, however, that I am ignorant of the happenings of the world. I have a very fast broadband fiber coming to my house, and I am all too well aware of what is going on. Wars, famine, floods, insurrections, even in our own country, the land of the free. There is bigotry and brutality and riots, and the list goes on and on. And I look around and I see these things, and I'm depressed and disappointed. I am saddened, and frankly, I'm disgusted. One would think that with humanity facing a worldwide epidemic that sickens men and women and children with no regard to race, creed, or ethnic origin, that we as human beings might, or maybe should, might come together to fight this common enemy. And what I see instead is finger pointing and ignoring and blaming an argument. One would think that we would be concerned with keeping the healthy healthy. One would think that we would be concerned with treating the sick in improving health care and its delivery for all people, everywhere in the world. You see, when others are healthy, we stay healthy. When others are lifted up, we are lifted up. Because we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. And among these rights are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Sound familiar on the 4th of July? And yet we are not happy. We don't have real liberty. And far too many of our lives are too short. I'm going to switch gears here for a minute, and if you bear with me, you'll see where this is going. My in-laws were married at the beginning of July, and we celebrated their anniversary with a party last weekend. We rented the entire town park, and most of us wore our masks, and we practiced social distancing. Now, in case you're wondering, they were married in 1950, which is 70 years ago. They invited a deacon that they have known far longer than they have known me. And that deacon helped them to renew their vows. He preached from a poem by an early Catholic mystic. I don't recall her name. The gist of it was that although two become one flesh in marriage and stand together, a husband and wife should not stand too close together. That is, two individuals working together complement one another and strengthen the union. They can't do that if they're the same. I know that my marriage, Nancy holds me up in my many weaknesses. And I've helped her with the one that she used to have. The point being is that this is what love does. It helps us hold one another up. It strengthens the relationship even with those differences between. I've thought about that homily all this week. And it's not just in marriage that differences can be strengthening. What about differences in our communities or between nations? What about differences in color or religion? These things don't need to separate us, but should strengthen us. A relationship shouldn't be about sameness. It should be about coming together, about becoming one, united in purpose, united in love. I'd like to take a moment and look at the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10. You'll remember this when I get into it. A scholar of the law asked Jesus what he must do to inherit eternal. And Jesus, in turn, quizzes him and says, well, what is written in the law? And the scholar responds, you shall love the Lord your God, excuse me, with all your heart and with all your being and with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. Jesus tells him, that's very good. Do this and you shall live. But then the scholar asks, who is my neighbor? You know this story. A man traveling from Jerusalem to Jericho is robbed and beaten and left for dead. A priest and a Levite each pass by. But a Samaritan, with pity, binds his wounds and cares for him. Who is the neighbor? Jesus tells the scholar, go and do likewise. So who is your neighbor? The story should conclude that everyone is your neighbor. Black or white, rich or poor, the man who wears the turban on his head and the woman who covers herself, they are our neighbors. The one who is covered with tattoos, the man who is clean shaven and wearing a suit, or the man in the dirty jeans who just came in from the barn. They are our neighbors. Republicans and Democrats, those next door, those in the next state, those in the next hemisphere, we are all neighbors. We are all created and loved by God. The scholar of the law said it right when he quoted and said, you shall love your neighbor. It is not written as a suggestion. It is a command. Do this, and you shall live, Jesus says. Back to my in-laws' party. They're in their 90s. They're both 91, actually. And the friends and family's ages ranged from their age down to 2 years old. I remember the kids that were playing. They ran across the fields together, and they were giggling. They had no cares in the world. They were loving. accepting of one another. They were not all the same color. They come from families that are Catholic and fundamentalist, an agnostic family, and even an atheist family. But the kids didn't care. They played and they had fun together. In today's gospel reading, Jesus praises God, saying, "Father, you have revealed, you have hidden things from the wise and the learned, but revealed them to the little ones." How wise and learned we all think we are. But it's the kids who really know. They don't care about brown skin or curly red hair or the one that likes to wear a hat and a bow tie, or the other who had shorts and flip-flops. They were just together and having fun. The divisions we see between neighbors carry a heavy toll. Hatred and bigotry and animosity stress us, all of us, both physically and psychologically. These things lead to anxiety and depression and possibly even suicide. Physical symptoms can be loss of sleep, high blood pressure, heart attack, stroke. It takes hard work to carry this luggage that we're carrying individually and as a nation. It's unhealthy to boot. It's time to put that luggage down. Jesus tells us, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened. Put your burdens down and I will give you rest." His yoke is easy and his burden is light. So stop worrying about the differences that we have. Embrace them. And try to remember that God created everything. All of us. And we're all different. And God loves us all. And so should we. It's healthier that way.
Stand up now as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds with the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. As Jesus is our hope and our life, we now make the following petitions.
That those burdened with fear, anxiety, and grief may They experience Christ's transforming love to bring them peace of mind, body, and spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. That the world may soon be relieved of the burden of the virus crisis, so that all people may grow in peace, good health, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are weighing themselves down with anger, hate, and grudges, that Christ's healing presence may wash away the pain in their hearts and minds. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all children, born or unborn, may enjoy healthy, positive environments to thrive in, especially in their households and through good role modeling of love and faith from parents and guardians. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That holiday weekend travelers may enjoy safety and peace in their activities. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are burdened with physical or mental illness may find comfort and hope from the power of God's Spirit, especially Clara Butler, Pierre Rivière, Blanche Collins, and those listed in our bulletin and in our prayer book of requests. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in faith and hope in Christ may enjoy eternal rest in heaven, especially Jane Wood, Father Frank Burton, and our deceased family members, friends, and parishioners. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our special intention is for Mario Sabatini. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For any prayers that you offer now in silent prayer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And on this 244th birthday of our country, let's also say a special prayer for God to heal the sad divisions that lie between us and our nation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who know that our life in this present age is subject to much suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry out to you, and receive the prayers of those who believe in you. We make all these prayers through Christ, our Lord.
Please join in singing the hymn of presentation found on your song sheet. Number 724, I Heard the Voice of Jesus Say.
Jesus, Savior.
message lives on in our midst as our task for today and a promise for tomorrow. And so with hearts full of love, we join the angels today and every day of our lives to sing your glory as we acclaim.
Amen.
Just a friendly reminder for community guidelines, please wait for prompting the usher to come up. Keep 6 feet apart, and we prefer that you receive the hand as a safety precaution. Thank you.
Thank you. Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.